I tell you what bothers me about coming in and hiking early in the morning. Spider webs. They're everywhere. And you're just walking and you keep getting tangled by spider webs pretty much everywhere. I don't like spiders. I don't like the way they look. I don't like the way they walk. I don't like the way the spider webs feel in your face or pretty much anywhere in your body. And early in the morning seems to be spider webs all over. That's the one thing that I don't like about hiking early in the morning. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it seems that there's a lot less spider webs later in the day. Hello guys, this is Jacko from Muddy Tiger Outdoors, enjoying a beautiful summer morning. Today we're just kind of hiking some of the local trails and trying to enjoy the weather before it gets too hot. We've been reaching mid 90s to upper 90s for the last couple of weeks, I believe. But today's video is going to be basically a video response to Mr. Zed Outdoors. He very recently achieved, I think it's 1,000 subscribers. So that is a major achievement in my opinion, and I'm sure in the opinion of a lot of YouTube users or people that make videos. If you've never watched Mr. Zed Outdoors' channel, I'm going to go ahead and put in a link in the description of this video. It's a great channel. He's got a lot of beautiful videos and a lot of useful information, a lot of bushcraft content. So it's a great channel to go and check out. I don't know if you can hear, but there's a lot of beautiful noises out here this morning. A lot of birds singing, and just trying to contribute to the video. I like that. So Mr. Zed Outdoors challenged some of his viewers, or a lot of his viewers, to come up with three life lessons, or I guess you would also call it three philosophies for life. And, you know, I got probably about a week since I watched his video and got to think, okay, what can I say that it's going to be meaningful and it's going to, you know, be understood from a lot of the views out there. The thing is that when you come up with your philosophies, sometimes they make perfect sense in your head, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to make sense for somebody else. So I'm going to try my best to explain this. I believe that we all should have that helping nature. What I mean by that is, you know, every time I have a chance to stop by the side of the road and, you know, help someone with car trouble, or anyway, I had to pause the video. There were some people walking by and I didn't want them to think that I was a little off. But yeah, what I mean by that is, you know, just have any time you have the opportunity to help somebody carry something, to stop by the side of the road, to it may sound stupid or cliche, but you know, help them cross the street, you know, things like that. I know it sounds silly, but that is something that I have always believed. And you know, I don't tell people, hey, guess what I did today? I helped this guy that ran out of gas, and I even took him to the gas station and, you know, filled up his little extra container of gasoline and took him back to his car and refilled his fuel tank. I don't tell people that, and I don't think it's a thing that you should do as far as when you help. But you know, it's something that gives me a huge reward when I know that I've done something for somebody, even though if I don't know them. So it's a great thing. Now, as far as my second life lesson or philosophy, it may sound a little bit silly too, but you know, sometimes we just get caught up in being busy and being at work and, you know, using our cell phones and all kinds of electronic devices or whatever it is that we do. And we kind of forget to enjoy the little things, you know, such as this, you know, coming out for a walk early in the morning, enjoying the sun, the sounds from the birds. You know, I just saw a hawk flying over there. And, you know, we tend to overlook those things. We forget how important they are. We forget how beautiful they are. And, you know, when we do that, we just kind of, we almost become like zombies. We almost don't pay attention to our surroundings and enjoy or try to enjoy as much as we can.
I think that's a very important thing to do, just enjoy little things. You know, if have the chance to eat your favorite snack or your favorite treat, you know, you just kind of, sometimes we get caught up with, you know, eating so fast and we don't even enjoy it. I mean, you know, take your time to enjoy your meal, take your time to enjoy a drink, water, take your time to, you know, wake up in the morning and you know, tell yourself, you know what, I enjoyed being in bed and getting some good night's sleep and, you know, resting, you know, just things like that. And I think that if we could all at least find 3 to 5 things every single day that we enjoy that are minimal, you know, not big things, not like, ooh, I bought a new car today, or, oh, guess what, I got me an expensive watch today, or I bought, you know, 5-6 things on Amazon. You know, not things like that, you know, more like, you know, I saw the sun come out today, or, you know, that's a beautiful looking cloud. I think that's something that it's important to, you know, not forget to enjoy the little things. Now for my third life lesson or philosophy, I'm going to do this walking and I hope I don't get too distracted to where I step on a snake or, you know, step on a spider web. That would be definitely worse. You know, and this is something that is very personal to me, and I know probably my mom is going to watch this video, my wife and my brother and my grandparents, my dad, they're probably going to watch this video. And to me, a very personal, important thing that I would like to share with everybody is, you know, try to spend more time with your family, or friends or people that are close to you. You know, once again, as we get very busy throughout our days and, you know, with work and responsibilities and all that kind of stuff, we just kind of forget to, you know, reach out or to spend some more time. And I'm guilty of this. I know that I could do better. I know that I could be a little closer to people that I care about. I know that I could, you know, make more sympathetic gestures, or maybe, you know, just say things that sometimes need to be said more often. And, you know, I do appreciate my family. I think I've been blessed with a wonderful family. You know, my parents, my brother, my wife, my grandparents that are probably also going to watch this video, even though they speak Spanish and they may not understand 100% of the things that I'm saying. You know, I always send them my videos. I always want to share what I do. They enjoy it. You know, they get to watch me, I guess, on their computer. But yeah, that's the main thing that I, you know, cherish, and it's my family. That would be my third philosophy. Just, I guess it all the three philosophies tied in together, you know, helping, which is my main one, you know, always be willing to sometimes even go out of your way to help people, to, you know, make a difference, I guess. Yeah, to lend a hand. You know, the second one being enjoy the little things, and that includes everything. That includes enjoy your family, enjoy helping, enjoy your work, enjoy, you know, taking a deep breath of fresh air, whatever it is that you need to enjoy. Just don't forget that you enjoy it and why you enjoy it. The third one, you know, keep your family and your friends close. I think that's a great thing to believe in. Anyway, Mr. Zed Outdoors, once again, congratulations for your big achievement, your 1,000 subscribers, and I hope you get plenty more, and I know you will, because you're a great guy. So far, the conversations that we've had on YouTube, even though you're in the other side of the world, and you are in a different continent, you're a very warm guy. You always seem to say the right thing. You always seem to be very friendly, very charismatic, and I tell you what, man, I do enjoy your videos. Every time you post a new one and I get that email that Zed Outdoors just posted a new video, you know, as soon as I can, I always click on it and watch what you've done. So, yeah, big, big congratulations to you, man. I've had some upper respiratory issues, and I even had to miss work one day of the week. I wasn't feeling too good, but I'm starting to come out of it, and I'm gonna be trying to do more videos. Maybe not so much reviews and things like that, but you know, more of this, just coming out here and, you know, just even if it's shooting a video of me walking with a camera, I point it to my moneymaker, walking through the bush. Wow, that smells really good. I just smelled something really good. And I'm not being sarcastic. I think it's honeysuckle. My wife seems to be very knowledgeable when comes to plants and herbs and flowers and all that kind of stuff. And I wish she was here, but she's feeling worse than I am as far as upper respiratory. And I think it's that plant over here. I'm not sure, that might be the one that smells great. But then there's another plant right here with a lot of small, pretty little flowers. I don't know. I guess I'll do a quick pan of the area. If you guys identify something that may be smelling very sweet, very strong, and very pleasant, see what you guys think. So Mr. Zed Outdoors, this video was meant to be for you, and I kind of got sidetracked with plants and flowers, but yeah, man, I mean, even though you're far away, just kind of want to let you know that your content and your videos and a lot of your words are definitely appreciated over here in the north side of Texas, at least. Yeah, I'm just going to continue my walk and enjoy the scenery.